I grew up in a regular from birth home, went to Beis Yaakov, and had kind, warm parents. Nothing from my childhood happened that was traumatic or would lead me to get into the problems I got into later in life, or at least nothing I can think of. When I got married, I was filled with idealistic views on how to build a Jewish home and how to create a beautiful marriage. I had never encountered anyone like my husband before, so I didn't understand what was going on. My husband was completely involved in his own life, his own needs, and had nothing to do with me. No matter what I asked of him, the answer was always, no, I have no time, if I wanted to talk to him, if I would need any help, even if I wanted to be with him physically. With intimacy, he would say, of course I want to be with you, but first I have to. And then he'd come to bed well after I was asleep. I felt completely alone. I asked him what I was doing wrong, and he would say I was the perfect wife. He would tell me he was so attracted to me that seeing other women in the street was no challenge for him because I was everything he could ever want. He'd constantly praise me and tell me that I protect him from the Yetzer Hara. The problem was, he didn't protect me. I was always super lonely. I felt really bad that he would only come to bed when he was desperate and wake me up at odd hours. I felt like I didn't matter. Many, many instances occurred when he made me feel like nothing. What I said didn't matter. Whatever I needed, he didn't care. I started getting really depressed and went to see a therapist. It felt really good to discuss my pain with someone, but after several months, I saw that it wasn't helping. So I discontinued. Many months passed and I was still miserable. One day I got an email from my therapist asking me how I was doing. I was so touched. He's so sweet, I thought to myself. I quickly responded. One response led to another. The emails got longer and longer and more intense. He started telling me about his life and his struggles. We quickly became friends. He was everything I was missing. He grew into my best friend. We shared everything. I thought I loved him. Eventually, things became more and more inappropriate. The entire time, I felt horrible for what I was doing, having a relationship with a firm married man, being married myself. But I needed him. His love and his care meant everything to me. He was also so desperate to be with me physically. He would beg me to meet with him. He would promise he wouldn't touch me, just let's see each other. I knew this wasn't possible. I knew that if I'd see him, I would not be able to hold back. The urge to just go along with him was extremely powerful, but I'm grateful that I never gave in. He was very persistent, but I couldn't. I was very afraid to betray Hashem in such a devastating way. This relationship went on secretly for 3 years. Thankfully, I was never with him physically. I was tormented to be a Beis Yaakov girl doing such immoral things. I would often cry about it, but I just couldn't stop. I tried many times telling him it was over, but I'd keep going back to him. It was truly an awful existence. I was constantly torn about what I was doing. One day, I went to my OB and the doctor told me that it looks like my unborn child will have Down syndrome. This felt like a huge slap from Hashem. He was telling me I better stop what I was doing. I could not stop crying. I called my therapist. I told him it was over for real. He should never text me, email me, or call me ever again. I told him Hashem was punishing me for what I was doing. He said I was being foolish, but I didn't listen to him. The rest of the pregnancy was highly stressful. Would my baby be okay? Would Hashem protect him because I stopped my bad behavior? And then my baby was born. He was the most perfect and beautiful child. He did not have Down syndrome. He was actually more perfect than any of my other children. Or maybe I just see it that way because of what I had overcome and given up. I was overwhelmed with gratitude. Years went by and I missed my therapist badly. Every time I would almost call him, I would look at my son and stop myself. My son was extraordinarily smart and healthy and handsome. I knew I wouldn't go back to my immoral behavior. Many years passed by and the urge inside me did not go away. I foolishly pined for this man. One night, after a huge fight with my husband, I texted my therapist and asked if he had remembered me. He said, of course, and things got crazier than ever. His texts got very explicit, and I was out of control. I started sending him Nazis pictures of me. It was just terrible. One day, someone told me she watched a movie that kept her up all night. I asked her what the movie was. She told me it was the Gehenna movie by Rabbi Yaron Reuven. That night, I looked it up. I was shaken to the core. I understood why my friend was up all night. I sent frantic texts to Rabbi Reuven. He patiently and kindly answered each one of them. I knew I needed to change my life. It was a process, but after having my questions answered and following Rabbi Reuven's advice, I started to change. I kept watching more videos, whichever ones he suggested. He also told me to stop watching movies and TV shows so that I don't have all that garbage in my head. I told him that was impossible for me to stop. He encouraged me to try. Now it's been several months and I've never watched a movie or TV show again. I didn't think this was possible. Now I only listen to Shiur Torah. I feel completely different. While before it was super hard for me not to talk to my therapist, now I am angry with him and I no longer pine for him. My whole outlook is different now. My husband started listening to the Jewish Intimacy series with me. It's just a whole new world. My life has a whole new purpose, a whole new direction. Things with my husband are much better. He realizes that he has to work on the relationship. We are more connected and happier than ever. The shiur that affected me the most was the Jewish Intimacy series. I always thought that if I wasn't actually cheating, it wasn't so bad. I now have a much deeper understanding. I wanted to point out something so interesting. Since watching this Jewish Intimacy series and the incredible videos that BeEzrat HaShem has put out, like Tikkun HaBrit, I have tremendously worked on my tznius. I am careful with the way I dress, and some of the things I loved wearing before, I won't wear now. I'm also very careful with my interactions with men and my general behavior. One might think that when I behave and look much more modest, my husband would find me less attractive. Yet the opposite is true. He will constantly tell me how I'm much more beautiful now than when we got married over 2 decades ago. He himself finds this surprising. Not only that, when I go anywhere with my 5-year-old, people ask me, "Oh, is this your oldest child?" When I tell people that I have a 20-year-old, they are generally shocked and will comment that I myself look like I'm in my 20s. This literally happens to me all of the time. Being modest and careful about the way I behave and dress has only brought me endless blessings. What I recommend to others, to people that just think something is too hard for them to overcome, don't give up. Hashem will help you. Always keep trying and ask Hashem to help you. I thought I would never get over my therapist, but now he disgusts me. I thought I would never stop watching movies, but once I made the effort, it was not as hard as I thought. Hashem is here for you and wants to help you. Also, look for the truth, even if it's painful. It's so valuable. Don't look for people that will just make you feel better. If you don't have the truth, it's just not worth anything. I spoke to another Rav about my situation before I ever contacted Rabbi Reuven, and he told me, this other Rav, that if I have another man in my head during intimacy, as long as I'm not having children, it's okay. I was told several lies. If something doesn't sound right, push further, look into sources. Don't allow yourself to be pacified. This will not help you in this world or in the next. I'm super, super, super grateful that my life now looks completely different. Following the Torah is the only way to happiness. One last thought I wanted to share. I spoke to a few women who have physically cheated. They all say the same thing. They feel absolutely horrible afterwards. For a momentary pleasure, they are completely destroying themselves, and it will bring utter misery in this world and in the next. They always bitterly regret it. One woman told me she would constantly consider suicide. She felt she could no longer exist. I told her not to lose hope. She can always do tshuva. She needs to run and grab the opportunity before it's too late. She should cling to Hashem and never let go. She should find the truth and immerse herself in it. Her whole life will change.
To be honest with you, to give this lecture is a nightmare. If it was up to me, I wouldn't do it. There's going to be some graphic details.
Not Midrashim, not Gemarot. We did that already. Where is Genom in Halacha?
what did the Hasidim actually say about punishment? Is there suffering? Is there a physical place of fire or snow? We're simply trying to verify that Hashem takes vengeance against the sinners or not.
Do you believe that angels, demons exist?
We're doing a Ouija board video today.
This is by far the largest near-death experience study that has ever been conducted.
What happens the moment you die? Person needs to know that he's not going to be a friend.
Yeah, I went to a place of timelessness.
It was me judging myself on what I could have done better.
Not the rebuke of some book. This is a rebuke of HaKadosh Baruch Hu when we go up to Shamayim.